Ogeno, Minister of Water Resources, Irrigation and Energy of Ethiopia, dear TNC members and supporting experts of Ethiopia, Egypt and Sudan, dear colleagues, ambassadors and representatives of our diplomatic missions in Cairo, dear representatives of the media here present today, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. At the outset, let me express our great thanks and appreciation to the very usual hospitality that has been accorded to me and my delegates since our arrival at home in Cairo, in this lovely city. So thank you very much indeed for the very generous arrangements that has been put in place by Egypt and the Ministry of Water Resources and Irrigation, and all excellent arrangements we are enjoying today. Dear all here present, you may have noticed that we have gained momentum on GERD, and we sincerely hope that this will be our way forward always in cooperation, especially in the Eastern Nile and the Nile Basin at large. Because cooperation today is for the people of the River Nile, we are now exceeding 200, approaching 300 millions, and we have to take the River Nile as one system and look at it, try to share the benefits and avoid any significant harm on our people at large. I indeed request us all to exert whatsoever effort possible to promote and foster cooperation among us. I urge on politicians, media, and the people of the Nile in the three countries to work hard to create a conducive environment for trust and confidence, to let cooperation grow and avoid unnecessary statements that create disputes and further deepen unnecessary division and foster mistrust and lack of confidence. I equally urge upon other related ministries among our countries and stakeholders to be equally honest and take cooperation as a package, that we have to take it all or leave it all. There is no shortcut in cooperation. It is indeed, there are dues for cooperation. However, the cost of no cooperation exceeds by far the dues of cooperation. Now, the whole world, development partners, major players on the River Nile, they watch us all in this room here, and they want to see the fairest deliverable due on investment projects, because this is now the fairest project on ground that we need to talk about, and we need to find our fair way forward. So we want this example to be echoed worldwide as an international good practice. And indeed, Ethiopia, Sudan, and Egypt, they deserve being quoted worldwide as a good practitioner and to set an example, a reference example to the whole world to learn. Egypt, Ethiopia, and Sudan, they have a great history. Each respective country has thousands of years back of history of civilization. We need to create a new section on this civilization by coming on an agreeable way forward on the agenda we have before us, being GERD, to set an example for the whole world to learn from the way we are doing it. So let us try to move and reset our minds for a wide regionalization and get out from the narrow nationalization, which will always bring contradictory agenda that may divide us rather than bring us together. Hence, let us work together in good faith and trust and confidence. Let us send a message to the whole world and to our region that we are denying our differences. We are now working together in peace and harmony for our people, for their peace and prosperous future. In conclusion, let me renew again our confidence in our institutional setup, the TNC, the supporting experts, that they will advise us, guide us wisely on a fair technical basis to come together on the agenda before us. May Almighty bless us all. Thank you very much indeed. And thank you again, Egypt, for the excellent arrangement made.